Good morning everybody, welcome to my channel Vijay's Physics Sprints. Today we'll discuss about NEET 2020 physics solutions from 91 to 135 in G3. And the first question, it is 91, the phase difference between displacement and acceleration of the particle in SHM, simple harmonic motion. In SHM, the acceleration of the particle is directly proportional to displacement in the opposite direction. So the phase difference between acceleration and displacement is indicating with delta phi, which is equals to pi radian. So the answer it is fourth option. Now the question number 92 question, it is related to solenoid. See the question in solenoid. A long solenoid 50 centimeter length it is mentioned, 50 centimeter we have to convert into meter, and number of turns it is given n as 100 turns, carries the current is 2.5, the value of I current, and magnetic field at the center of the solenoid we have to calculate. So due to the solenoid, the magnetic field at the center is B equal to mu naught Ni by L, where mu value is given 4.2 10 power of minus 7, I am substituting here, minus 7, number of turns it is 100, current is given by 2.5 ampere, and length of the solenoid 50 centimeter, converting into the meter. So therefore, you will get the answer is B equal to 6.28 10 power of minus 4 Tesla. So the answer it is fourth option, right? Next. Coming to the next question, 93. See the question number 93 question. It is based on the Atwood machine. See the question, first of all, two bodies is given. Mass 4 kg and 6 kg are tied to the ends of massless string. The string passes over the pulley. You can see the diagram also. Frictionless. And the acceleration of the system in terms of acceleration due to gravity, you have to calculate. So the acceleration of the system can be written as A equal to A, acceleration of the system equals to M1 minus M2 G by M1 plus M2. This is the value of M1 and this is the value of M2. Substituting here, that is 6 minus 4 g, keep it as it is, 6 plus 4, that is equals to 2g by 10, cancellation with the 2, so the acceleration of the system becomes g by 5, so therefore the option it is 2. Okay, now coming to the next question, the contribution of the ratio of contribution made by the electric field and the magnetic field components intensity is given as intensity of the electromagnetic waves. We have to calculate, and C is the speed of the light. Okay, see, the ratio of contribution made by electric field and magnetic field components, nothing but UE by UB. The ratio, it is equals to 1:1, because the electric and magnetic components, the intensity of these electric and magnetic components remains same. UE equal to of epsilon naught E square, and UB equal to B square by 2 mu naught, which is the ratio is equals to 1:1 in electromagnetic waves. So the option it is 1. Now coming to the next question, it is 95. In a certain region, see the question, the certain region, the space of volume is given 0.2 meter cube and potential is found to be 2 volt throughout. So throughout the given area, the potential remains 5 volt, no change. So potential V is 5 volt, which is constant. okay, and we had to calculate magnitude of electric field. What is the magnitude of electric field? You had to calculate. We know equal to minus dv by dr, but v is constant, right? So E equal to minus d by dr, value is 5, which is equals to 0 electric field. So the option it is 4. Now coming to the next one, the next question, it is 96. So the question, the average thermal energy of monoatomic gas. Monoatomic gas has 3 degrees of freedom. 3 degrees of freedom, right? So therefore, the energy can be written as E equal to, the formula is F by 2 kBT. F is number of degrees of freedom. For monoatomic gas, it is 3 degrees. So therefore, the energy becomes 3 by 2 kBT. So the answer it is 1. Now coming to the next one, next question, 97. Find the torque about origin when the force is given 3 j cap newton acts on a particle whose position vector is given r bar 2 k cap. So torque is nothing but tau is equals to r bar cross f bar. It is given by 2 k cap cross 3 j cap. So 2 3 is a 6, k cap into j cap, k cap into j cap equal to minus k cap. So the answer it is tau is equals to minus k cap newton meter. So the answer it is second one. Now coming to the next one. Next, it is 98. It's a direct question. It's a formula based directly. Mean free path of gas with molecular diameter d and number of density is given n can be expressed as. So the mean free path can be written as L bar equal to 1 by root 2 pi n d square. So the option it is 98. Now the next one, question number 99. Energy is required equivalent to 0.5 grams. Mass it is mentioned 0.5, so 0.5 into 10 power of minus 3 kg. So we need to calculate energy. E equal to mc square. Mass is given 0.5 into 10 power of minus 3. C, speed of light. Speed of light is 3 into 10 power of 8 meter per second. So C square, it is 9 into 10 power of 16. So after multiplying 4.5 into 10 power of 13 joules. So the option it is 1. Now coming to the next one. Question number, right? See the question number 100. Question number 100. See the question. Least count is given 0.01 millimeter and number of divisions is 100 in a circular scale. So we have to calculate pitch of the screw gauge. So pitch of the screw gauge can be written as least count is multiplying with the number of divisions on circular scale. So that is equals to 0.01 into number of divisions is given by 50. So therefore, the pitch becomes 0.5 mm. So the answer it is second one. Now the next one. Question number 101. So two cylinders A and B, equal capacity, volume is same, capacity connected to each other via stop cock, contains an ideal gas, standard temperature and pressure, base completely evacuated, entire the system is thermally insulated, means temperature of the system remains constant. So the stop clock is suddenly opened, temperature remains constant, the temperature of the system remains constant. So in adiabatic, heat is constant. In isochoric, volume is constant. Isobaric, pressure is constant. But only in isothermal, the temperature is constant. So therefore, the answer it is, fourth one is this isothermal process. Okay. Now question number 102. The cylinder contains hydrogen gas. Mass of hydrogen is 2 grams. Mass it is, okay, and pressure it is 249 kilopascal. So 249 into 10 power of 3 pascals. Temperature is 27 degrees Celsius, which is equal to 300 Kelvin, and R value is given 8.3 joule per mole Kelvin. And we have to calculate the density. According to ideal gas equation, P equal to rho RT by m. Okay, so we need to calculate the rho value, that is P, pressure into mass, RT. So substituting here, that is 249 into 10 power of 3 hydrogen, it is 2 into 10 power of minus 3 gram molecular weight, and this is 8.3, temperature is 300 Kelvin. After solving, the density of the hydrogen gas becomes 0.2 kg per meter cube. So the answer it is first option. Okay, now the next one, next question. See the question number 103. So nuclear reaction is given. Uranium isotope 92 to 35 is bombarded with neutron, generates krypton 3689 and as well as 3 neutron, and we have to calculate the remaining nucleus. So uranium 92 to 35 is bombarding with neutron, it releases barium 56 141, krypton 36 92, 3 neutrons and 200 MeV of energy. So the missing nucleus, it is barium 141, right? The 144. So answer it is fourth option. Okay, now the next one, the next question, it is 104. See, the drift velocity is given 7.5 10 power of minus 4 meter per second. Electric field, it is 3 into 10 power minus 10. So we had to calculate the mobility. Mobility mu equal to drift velocity by electric field intensity. So drift velocity is given 7.5 10 power of minus 4. Electric field, it is 3 into 10 power of minus 10. So after solving, you will get as 2.5 into 10 power of 6 meter square per volt second. Right? So the answer it is first option. Now the next one, next question. Next question, it is 105. Is a subtraction of significant figures, right? So 9.99 minus of 0.0099, it gives 9.9801. So it has 3 significant figures. So the answer also consists of 3 significant figures, 9.98. So the option it is 1. Now the next question, number 106. Iron rod is given. Its susceptibility value psi is given 599. and magnetizing field 1200 ampere per meter. Permeability of the rod you have to calculate. So permeability mu can be written as mu naught 1 plus psi. Psi is a susceptibility. Mu is equals to mu naught 4 pi into 10 power of minus 7 1 plus 599. 599 plus 1, that is 600. 600 is multiplying with 4 pi into 10 power of minus 7 into 600, which gives the value of 2.4 into 10 power of minus 4 Tesla meter per ampere. So the answer it is 4th. Now coming to the next one. Next question. See, the question is a very easy question. Direct question is mentioned. Radius is given 10 cm of the spherical conductor. Charge Q is 3.2 10 power of minus 7 distributed uniformly. What is the magnitude of electric field at the point of 15 cm from center of the sphere? Electric field intensity can be written as E equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught can be written as 9 into 10 power 9. Q is 3.2 into 10 power of minus 7. Distance is 15 centimeter, converting into meter. So R square, so 15 whole square. So after calculating, the electric field intensity becomes 1.28 10 power of 5 Newton per coulomb. So the option it is 1. Now the next one. Right, question number 108. LCR circuit is given when L is removed. L removed means only we have right capacitor and as well as resistor. Phase difference is mentioned as pi by 3. So tan phi equal to x c by R. tan phi is nothing but pi by 3 equal to x c by R. Tan phi can be written as root 3 equal to x c by R. So x c written as root 3 R equation 1. And similarly, now c removed means only remaining R L. Phase difference is same pi by 3, same using tan phi equal to xl by r. So therefore xl also will get same as xl equal to root 3 by r, equation number 2. Now we are calculating the phase difference. Tan phi equal to xl minus xc by r. Xl and as well as xc are same, therefore tan phi equal to 0. Then phi equal to 0 phase difference. But we need the power factor. Power factor can be written as cos phi, which is equal to cos 0. Cos 0 value 1. So option it is second one. Okay. Now the next question. The next one it is capillary tube. The capillary tube radius R immersed in water and water rises to in it at the height of H, and the mass of the water is given in the capillary tube is 5 grams, it is M1. Another capillary tube radius is 2R, R2 is 2R, and mass of the water you have to calculate. So we know that the mass of water in the capillary tube, M is proportional to R, that is M2 by M1 equal to R2 by R1. M2, M1 is 5 grams and this is 2R by R. So therefore M2, which is equals to 10 grams of water, is occupied in the second capillary tube. Now coming to the next problem. See, the next problem it is Young's double slit experiment. Young's double slit experiment. If the separation between coherent sources of so D2 is equals to D/2 and of and distance from the screen from the coherent source is doubled, so D2 is equals to 2D, then fringe width, how the fringe width is going to be changed? Fringe width equation, beta equal to lambda D/D, that is beta 1 equal to D2/D1 into D1/D2. So B2, initial fringe width is taken as beta, now it is becomes double 2D, initially is D, now initially is distance between the sources is D, now it is becomes half D/2. So beta 2 can be written as 4 into beta. So the fringe width increases 4 times. Okay, the next one. Next question it is, logic gates. Okay, see the question it is, for the logic circuit, the truth table it is, what happens the truth table? See the diagram, it is A is a input, is a NOT gate becomes A bar, B it is becomes B bar. Now A bar, B bar is the input for the NOR gate. NOR gate output it is, general output it is A+B bar. But the input it is A bar and second input it is B bar. So output from the NOR gate becomes A+B bar. According to the De Morgan principle, A+B written as A̅ (B)̅. So it is expanding like this, A̅(B)̅). A̅ which is equals to A. So A̅(B) which indicates AND gate. So the truth table AND gate it is 4th option. Okay. Now the next one, it is based on color coding of resistance. Right, yellow first band, second is violet, third it is brown, and fourth it is gold. Fourth band indicates the tolerance, gold it is ±5%. According to color code, yellow it is 4, violet is 7, brown it is 1. So the resistance of the given carbon resistor it is 47 into 10 power of 1 ±5%, which is equals to 470 ±5%. So option it is 3. Now coming to the next one, next problem 113. The capacitance of parallel plate capacitor with air is a medium. Air is a medium given by C0 6 microfarad. With introduction of the dielectric medium, the capacitance becomes 30 microfarad with medium 30 microfarad. So what is the dielectric constant of the material? K can be written as C/C0, that is 30/6, that is K equal to 5 is the dielectric constant of the medium. So we need to calculate permittivity of the medium. Permittivity epsilon equal to K into epsilon naught, that is epsilon equal to K is 5, epsilon naught is already given 8.85 into 10 power of minus 12. So after solving we will get 0.44 into 10 power of minus 10 coulomb square per newton meter square. So option it is 2. Right, now next coming to the next question 114. Question number 114. So a ball is thrown vertically downwards, vertically downwards with a velocity of 20 meter per second. 20 meter per second. So vertically downwards like this, when reaches to ground, its velocity is 80 meter per second, and when it is thrown downwards, its velocity is 20 meter per second. The height of the tower you have to calculate. According to the third equation of motion, that is v square minus u square equals to 2as, that is 80 square minus 20 square equal to 2. A is nothing but gravity. The value is 10 meter per second square. That is 6400 minus 400 equal to 20 into h. Then h becomes 6000 by 20. That is h is equal to 300 meter. Okay. Now the next problem, the next one, 115. The weight of the body is 72 Newton on surface of the earth. What is the gravitational force on it? Then height is equals to half of the radius. So h is given by 2. H is equals to r by 2. At this height, what is the weight of the body? So at this height, what is the acceleration due to gravity? Gh is equals to 1g by 1 plus h by r whole square. G by 1 plus h is becomes r by 2. Then gh is equals to rr cancel after LCM, 3 by 2 whole square. So gh is equals to 4g by 9, but we need the value of weight w equal to mg, w proportional to g, w2 by w1 equal to g2 by g1. On surface of the earth it is 72 Newton. G2 it is 4g by 9, on surface it is g. After calculation, the value of w2 is becomes 32 Newton. So answer it is first option. Okay, now the next one, the next question, it is 116. Two particles of masses 5 kg and 10 kg respectively attached to ends of rigid supports. Rigid rod of length is 1 meter. This is 5 kg and this is 10 kg. And the length of rod it is 1 meter. So the center of mass of the system from 5 kg, we have to calculate. Just imagine the 5 kg at the origin, let xc is the center of mass. Okay, so xc is equals to m1x1 plus m2x2 by m1 plus m2. M1 is 5 kg at the origin, c0, and m2 at the distance of 1 meter, 5 plus 10, which is equals to 10 by 15, that is xc is equals to 2 by 3, 0.66 meter or 66.67 centimeter. So answer it is second option. Okay. Now the next one, it is 117. The increase in the width of depletion layer. Depletion layer width increases in the reverse bias, decreases in the forward bias. So the option it is reverse bias. Only in the reverse bias the width of depletion layer increases. Now the next one is 118. Light frequency 1.5 times of threshold frequency. Frequency is 1.5 times of threshold frequency. Incident on photosensitive material. what will be the photoelectric current if the frequency is halved? The frequency now becomes half of the threshold frequency. Intensity is doubled. The photocurrent depends upon, right, intensity of the material, but the frequency it is, but the frequency it is half of the threshold frequency. To get the electrons, to eject the electron, the frequency must be greater than or equal to threshold frequency. The incident frequency must be greater than or equal to threshold, but in this case the incident frequency is half of the incidence, half of the threshold, so therefore no electrons are ejected, therefore the current becomes zero. Okay, now the next one. Assume that the wavelength of the light is given lambda, 600 nanometer, 600 into 10 power of minus 9 meter, the conversion. Next, from the star, the limit of resolution you have to calculate, okay, whose object has diameter 2 meter. Diameter is given 2 meter, diameter is D. So the limit of resolution we have to calculate, that is small d equal to 1.22 lambda by d, that is 1.22 lambda, 600 into 10 power of minus 9, this is 2. Okay, so therefore d becomes 3.66 10 power of minus 7 radian, so option it is 4. Now coming to the next problem, the resistance wire is connected in the left gap of the metal bridge is 10 ohms. In the right gap, at a point divides the bridge wire in the ratio of 3:2. Okay, if the length of the resistance wire is 1.5 meter, then the length of 1 ohm you have to calculate. So we know that the ratio is given according to the Wheatstone bridge condition, P by Q equal to R by S. So the value of R by S is given 3/2, but the right, the left gap 10 ohms is connected, that is R by 10, which is equals to 1.5, that is R is equals to 15 ohm. But we need the length of the wire for 1 ohm, length of wire for 1 ohm, that is equals to 1.5 by 15, that is 1 into 10 power of minus 1 meter. Okay, now coming to the next problem, the light and average 20 watt per meter square, 20 watt per meter centimeter square, remember this is centimeter square, falls on non-reflecting surface at normal incidence having surface area and energy received, you have to calculate in the time of 1 minute. So energy E or Q equal to intensity area into time. Intensity is 20 into 10 power 4 watt per meter square, I converted into meter square. Area, this is 20 into 10 power of 4 centimeter square, also converted. Time is 1 minute, nothing but 60 seconds. So after calculation, the energy, it becomes Q equal to 24 into 10 power of 3 joules. So option it is 2. Now the next problem, the rays incident an angle of incidence I, okay, surface of small angle prism with angle prism A, emerges normal from the opposite surface perpendicular, so angle of emergence becomes 0. If the refractive index of the material of prism is mu, the angle of incidence I value have to calculate. We know for thin prism, delta is angle of deviation A into mu minus 1, and A plus delta equal to I plus E, but here E normally from opposite surface, so E value goes to 0, then I becomes A plus delta, substituting the value of delta in angle of, that is I is equals to A plus A mu minus A, cancelled out, then angle of incidence is equals to A mu, so option it is 2, right? The next problem is 123. 40 microfarad capacitance is given, connected to 200 volt, frequency is 50 hertz to AC supply, RMS value of current. This is a direct question it is, right? Let us calculate XC value, that is 1 by 2 pi FC, that is equals to 1 by 2 pi, frequency is 50 hertz, capacitance is given 40 microfarad, that is 10 power of minus 6. So it gives the value of XC is nearly 79.6 ohms. We need the current RMS current. IRMS is equals to VRMS by XC. The applied voltage is 200 and XC is nearly 79.6. Therefore, the IRMS becomes 2.5 ampere. Okay. Now, the next problem. Dimensions of stress is a very easy question. Stress is equals to force per area. Force ML T power minus 2. Area L square. So, that is ML minus 1 T power minus 2. So, option it is 3. Now, coming to the next problem. The Brewster's angle IB for interface should be the Brewster's angle in between 45 degrees to 90 degrees, right? The next one, the wire of length L is the initial length, area of cross section A, hanging from rigid support, fixed support, length of wire changes to L1. So what is elongation? Elongation is equal to final length minus initial length when mass M is suspended from the free end. The expansion, the expression for the Young's modulus Y equal to MGL by AE. This is the general expression for Young's modulus. Mass is given by M, G, initial length is L, elongation is becomes L1 minus L. So the option it is third. Next, the short dipole moment, electric dipole, as dipole moment is given by 16 into 10 power minus 9 coulomb meter. This is the electric dipole moment P value. And electric potential due to the dipole at a point, distance is given 0.6 meter from center of dipole. Situated line making an angle 60 degree with the dipole axis. At this dipole, due to this dipole, the potential can be written as V equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P cos theta by R square. V equal to 9 into 10 power 9 P dipole moment 16 into 10 power minus 9 cos 60, it is 1 by 2 R it is given by 0.6 whole square. Okay, after solving this value for V, V equal to can be written as 200 volt. So option it is 1. Now the next problem. In a guitar, two strings A and B is a concept of beats. Same material, slightly out of tune, produce 5 beats, so beats of frequency 6 hertz. When tension in B slightly decreased, beat frequency increases to 7 hertz. If the frequency of A is given by 530, and we have to calculate the value of B. So beat frequency is given by 6, that is NA minus NB equal to 6, that is 530 minus NB equal to 6. So NB can be written as 530 minus 6, which is 524 hertz. So answer it is 1. Now the next one. An electron is accelerated from the rest and potential difference is V volt. De Broglie wavelength of electron is mentioned as 1.227 nanometer. The potential difference we have to calculate. So we have the shortcut formula for De Broglie's wavelength for electron, that is lambda equal to 1.227 by root V. It is in nanometer. Value of lambda is given. Value of lambda is given 1.227 10 power of minus 2 equal to 1.227 by root V. So 1.227 cancelled out. Root V equal to 10 power minus 2. V equal to, 10 power plus 2. So V equal to 10 power of 4 volt. Okay. So the answer it is third option. Now the next one, 130. The solids which have negative temperature coefficient of resistance, nothing but alpha value negative. Okay, so alpha is negative means resistance is decreases with increase of temperature. Temperature rises. If temperature rises, its resistance is going to be decreases. So if temperature rises, the resistance decreases for insulators as well as semiconductors, so that alpha value is negative for these two materials. The next one, energy required to break the one bond of DNA 10 power minus 20 joule in electron volt. So we had to convert this joule into electron volt. Simply you had to divide with 1.6 into 10 power of minus 19, then you will get in electron volt. So therefore the answer is 0.0625 electron volt. So option it is second. Now the quantity of 132 question. Heat required to rise the temperature of two solid spheres. Radii given R1, R2, but R1 is 1.5 times of R2 through 1 Kelvin. So how much of heat required? Heat required Q equal to ms delta T. Mass given as density into volume. These two are in spherical shape. So volume of sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. Therefore the Q is proportionally to r cube. If you substituting the value of m in Q, Q1 by Q2 equal to R1 by R2 whole cube. R1 is 1.5 R2 by R2 whole cube cancelled out, that is 15 by 10 whole cube, right, cancelled, that is we will get 3 by 2, 3 cube 27 by 8. So this is the fourth option. Now the 133, the representation of variation of resistivity and temperature. The resistivity is varies exponential to temperature. So therefore the graph it is second. Next, 134. For transistor action, which of the following statement is correct? Base emitter and collector region should be have same size. This is wrong. Both emitter junction as well as collector junction are forward bias. No. Base region must vary thin and lightly doped. Emitter junction is heavily doped. Collector junction is moderately doped. Base junction is lightly doped and thin. So the answer it is third. Now the last one. For which one of the following Bohr model is not valid? It's valid for only single electron atom. Singly ionized helium consists of one electron. Deuterium 1H2 consists of one electron. Hydrogen atom consists of one electron. But neon singly ionized, so consists of 9 electron, so is not valid for neon, singly ionized neon atom. Okay, so thank you. Subscribe and share my channel. Thank you all. Have a great day.